Howdy, folks. Welcome to round two. Gonna try and rally back here. Yeah, this hand looks great. Got a couple of different options. We can go turn one Noble Hierarch into Grimflare, or we can just play a turn two Liliana of the Void, depending on what's appropriate for the matchup, right? I think I'm just gonna shock myself with the Temple Garden on turn one. Yep. And of course the Twilight Mire in our hand can double fix for the Liliana. So even though we don't have a black source on turn one, we can still... If the Temple Garden and the Twilight Mire had been fetches, then we would have had to start basically with an Overgrown Tomb to leave the option of Liliana, turn two Liliana on the table. Okay, Scavenging Ooze could be good. Don't hate that in this matchup. This is a matchup where a lack of Siege Rhinos in the main deck could hurt us. That's a big part of Junk's typical game one plan against Burn, is to play a couple of discard spells and then stick a Siege Rhino. And Siege Rhino is great, not just because it's a source of life gain against Burn, but also because it ends the game so quickly. You generally kill them the turn that you attack with it. Our opponent's name is Boros Charm, so that's not a misleading title at all by the looks of things. Okay, Searing Blaze. Be interesting to see if... Nope, it does in fact clear the Liliana. I'm pretty stoked about that. I'm going to hold off on the... I'm going to hold off on the Scavenging Ooze. Because right now I would just be playing the Scavenging Ooze and then activating it once. What I think I want to do is fetch a dual land into play tapped and either run out a Tarmogoyf or a Grimflayer this turn. I think it needs to be Tarmogoyf. I don't hate playing the Grimflayer, and then if it dies, it's just like more Scavenging Ooze food. But the problem with that is, one, the Tarmogoyf is applying a faster clock, and two, next turn I'm only going to have two extra mana for the Scavenging Ooze activation anyway, if that's what I want to be doing next turn. I think it is. I don't think we need to do two things this game. It depends, of course, if we really needed to Abrupt Decay for some reason, but I don't see it. Marsh Flats could fetch me a basic Swamp. Again, we've got two Twilight Mires here that can double fix for us, but I think it's going to be a Godless Shrine. There's the Eidolon. And I don't want to shrink the Tarmogoyf just yet. Yep, take two, gain two, have a 4/4. Seems great. Might be correct not to shrink my Goyf, but I'm going to. We can always pump the Goyf two by Abrupt Decaying the Eidolon, which would put both creature and enchantment in the graveyard. Getting the Scavenging Ooze out of burn range here seems kind of nice. And if they attack with the Eidolon, we can just snap block. And if they use burn to finish off the ooze, then we're still ahead because they used so much, so many resources to get to trade with the ewes, and then they're still pumping the Tarmogoyf again. So I don't think they can win that game. Obviously, we don't know what our opponent's hand is, but so far I feel very ahead. We can also just not block, right? And just lock them out of the game by attacking. Like, if we take this, we just drop down to 13, right? Is that even that big of a deal? Yeah, I kind of like pumping the Tarmogoyf, though. And we're technically representing lethal, so they either need to kill the Grim Flayer or produce some kind of a blocker, and the blocker plan doesn't work because of the abrupt decay. Not surprised to see a concession there. I don't think our line actually mattered, right? Like whether we blocked the Eidolon or didn't block the Eidolon. It's debatable which line is better, but they're both pretty advantaged, right? Okay, so I like the Lilianas. I like the removal. Mishra's Bauble is kind of an awkward card if the opponent gets an Eidolon of the Great Revels down, right? You don't want to, like, be stuck with a cantrip in your hand or top deck a cantrip and have to shock yourself to draw a card. But turning on Grim Flayer fast is really, really nice in this matchup. Our best card, looking at the main deck and sideboard, is the Collective Brutality. You can kill an Eidolon of the Great Revels while gaining your life back and duressing the opponent. Just a great, great card. Scavenging Ooze, also good. Some incidental life gain. The weak cards in the matchup are Lingering Souls. It's just a little bit too slow. A little bit too slow, too clunky. Just not very good in general. The Mishra's Bauble, like I pointed out earlier, but I think I'm going to keep those in. Again, like I've said, just to turn on the Grim Flayers and the Tarmogoyfs and whatnot. Oops. And then Thoughtseize is kind of awkward. You can play one, but drawing multiples is not really ideal. So basically I have to figure out if I want to shave Lingering Souls or Thoughtseize at all. So far we only brought in one card. On the draw. Yeah, I'm gonna cut one of each. And then either bring in the explosives or a Gideon. Let's try the Gideon out. It looks a little slow on paper, right? Especially on the draw. But it's not like the card that we cut for it was particularly good. And it's still I really like the idea of having cards that I can play through Eidolon of the Great Revel. That just appeals to me. Let's keep this. I think I'm going to be going turn one Noble Hierarch, as opposed to turn one Thoughtseize. Yeah, this is the sort of draw that is not very good against a turn one Goblin Guide, but not a whole lot I can do about that. And if the Hierarch lives, I can go Thoughtseize into something, and if the Hierarch doesn't live, then I can play Tarmogoyf as a speed bump, and then go Thoughtseize into Grim Flayer on turn three. Liliana of the Veil. Maybe another Liliana Edict game. Probably not, but possibly. Turn to Liliana Edict, rather. I wonder if seeing the Liliana incentivized my opponent to bolt the Noble Hierarch. Because they might not have otherwise, right? But then if they were worried about me sticking a turn to Liliana and Edicting. Oh, this looks like a path. Interesting. We don't currently have access to white mana, so I guess I'm supposed to grab that, right? One of the cool things about the post-board matchup with a slightly more typical junk shell is that the path to exile that they play on your Tarmogoyf ramps you into Siege Rhino. And sometimes you can get a Siege Rhino down well before your opponent is prepared to deal with it. Thought seizing the opponent when at 12 life doesn't feel very good. That was my uncomfortably casting a thought seize song. I'll be here all week. Let's see. Boros Charm, leave him with another Boros Charm. So we're dead to basically any 3 mana or 3 damage spell off the top. They do have a land drop. Opponents sandbagging the land, both because they know that I have a Liliana that I can uptick, and also because the land could potentially give them landfall for Searing Blaze, and they don't really need the mana currently. Grimflayer is mostly looking for Scavenging Ooze here. There's not very many cards that can actually pull me out of burn range, but that's one of them. Yep, that's a Boros Charm. We know we are out of basics to fetch. But that's fine, we're not going to be able to fetch afterwards anyway. We kind of need to clear the Eidolon. Because we're getting an 8 points of damage here. Get him down to 5. Yeah, dealing 4 is kind of good, but not quite good enough. Oh, interesting. Yeah, that one I'll keep. That'd be a terrific answer to an Eidolon, wouldn't it? And now, even a Searing Blaze without landfall kills us. Okay, yeah, that would have done the trick regardless. Did that change my thoughts on anything? I don't think so. I still like shaving the lingering souls in the Thoughtseize. Keeping everything else pretty much intact here. Let's run it. Oh, awesome. Yeah, this is exactly what I'm looking for. Nacatl, Goblin Guide, Eidolon. They only have one source of green. We could maybe bottleneck them on that. I don't want to take the Lava Spike because it's their only spell, and I want to be able to make them discard with the Collective Brutality, discarding Lingering Souls. Yeah, tricky stuff. If we did take a Nacatl and they went turn one Nacatl, we'd be able to collect a brutality it, which is kind of nice. You can also just take the Goblin Guide. Yeah, I think you can make an argument for taking any one of these three creatures. I'm gonna take a Nacatl. It helps their mana work out a little smoother. Like I said, now they only have one green card and one green source, so that it lets them play the Nacatl that they do have whenever they want. But the nice thing about taking a Nacatl is that now the Lingering Souls or a Grim Flare without Delirium, or the Collective Brutality, like all of my spells match up better against the remaining threats, right? Okay, looks like they're going for the turn one Goblin Guide. Do not blame them. Gideon, Ally of Zendikar, has entered the revealed card zone. Well, I know what second card I'm discarding now. If I discarded a creature, it'd be a little bit closer. Instead of just sorcery and planeswalker. I don't think I want to discard a Grim Flayer though. Yeah, I'm not doing that. Grim Flayers will die naturally. I believe. Okay. And they drew a Swift Spear. So I'm a little bit light on juice now. Compared to my opponent's hand. My opponent's hand is kind of stacked. Oh, nice. Do I just jam that? think so. I think I jammed that and then like regret not discarding a Grim Flayer. How bold do you think this Swift Spear attack is? You like kind of, they like kind of paused in the attack. What's my life total? 17. So if I take 4 here, go to 13, gain 2 up to 15 or whatever. I don't think they have a spell for that Swift Spear. We know 2 of the 3 cards in their hand. It's Eidolon and Land. I think they're just attacking because they think that that we can't block. But it'd be a pretty gutsy bluff to call, right? I'm gonna think about this one for a tick. If the Ooze Dying gave me Delirium, I'd be way more excited about calling a bluff here. One problem with not calling a bluff, if we just take the 4 and then they go Eidolon or whatever, is that next turn, if they just attacked with the Wild Nacatl, the Scavenging Ooze would kind of have to block it, and then an Atarka's Command would still clear it, assuming we didn't hit a land. If we just take this and then they run out Eidolon, then we activate twice and hope that they don't draw into a path to exile. Not the worst plan ever. Yeah, I'm more likely to call in to make the block in a situation like this than more likely than most people. Because the long end result is that I end up getting bluffed less often. Yeah, super close. In my mind, I think most people just don't feel like they can afford to block here. All right, let's take it. Yeah. Now we basically sit here and play losing Drago. I guess the Ooze could have attacked. If they go down to 9, then the Eidolon starts to get awkward. Our best draw here would be another Collective Brutality or maybe a Murderous Cut. Fetchland would be fine. It would let us play the Noble Hierarchy and Flashback the Lingering Souls. Though remember that flashing back Lingering Souls still domes me for the Eidolon. Alright, our opponent's got this going on. Now what if we just block Swift Spear? I don't think I can do that. I think I have to either block Nacatl, which loses to Atarka's Command pretty hard, or the Eidolon, which then frees them up to dump their spells. Alright, what you got, opponent? Alright, so we let the Eidolon die. And they're not finishing off the ooze. Yeah, so unless that last card in their hand is pretty good, I think the Swift Spear attack was a bluff the other turn. Shambling Vent is both a good draw and kind of an awkward draw, right? I think I'm just supposed to flashback this Lingering Souls. Yeah, I like that. Now if they attack, they lose a creature to the Scavenging Ooze, just like before. And we don't take damage because the spirits can jump off. And we can even continue to play around to Tarka's Command. Cool. We should be doing this on their upkeep. Yeah. Awesome. I should play the Noble Hierarch pre-combat to get the Exalted trigger here. But I wanted to see how they would block, right? There's a chance that I change my line of play this turn, depending on if they, like, double block or something weird. We're at 6 currently. Because I can run Noble Hierarch out as a chumper, but I don't think I want to do that. I think I just want to pass. Six life is such an even amount, right? Like if the opponent had two spells that dealt 3 damage or something like that, then I'd like to be able to gain a life by Abrupt Decaying a Wild Nacatl and activating the Ooze. Rift Bolt has entered the Exiled Zone. No Nacatl attacks. That is great for Team Caleb. Ah. Awesome. And I believe that is lethal. Phew. All right. getting a little bit of momentum back. As we all know, momentum wins tournaments, right? All right, on to round three. See you folks there.